One Sunday morning, President Calvin Coolidge, after attending a church service, returned to the White House. His wife asked, "How was the service, dear?" "Wonderful," he said. "How was the sermon?" "Good," he replied. "What was it about?" she asked. "Sin," he said. "Well, what did the minister say about it?" she asked. "Oh, he was against it." Well, in Paul's epistle to Timothy, Paul had much more to say about sin than Coolidge had to say. The greatest sin in our culture today is that many, including Christians, are disavowing and disclaiming the significance of sin. They are glossing over it and rejecting one of the most basic teachings of the Bible. The great evangelist Paul writes, "This is a true saying and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am first of them." Centuries before our Lord's birth, the great philosopher Aristotle said that the easiest person in the world to deceive is oneself. And the New Testament teaches, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. The saints write that it is the nature of sin to blind us to the reality of its spiritual disorder. We can ask, why is it that Paul considered himself the chief or the foremost of all sinners, whereas many Christians have no awareness of sin? The answer is that our sense of sin is in proportion to our nearness to the Lord. The closer we are to Jesus, the greater is our awareness of our shortcomings, of our failures. And the further we are from the Lord, the less spiritual awareness we have of sin. I recall reading about a cynic who said to a village priest, "You talk about burden of sin. I feel no burden. Tell me, Reverend," he said mockingly, "how heavy is sin supposed to be? 50 pounds? 100 pounds? And the old priest answered, "Tell me, son, if you lay 200 pounds of weight on a corpse, would he feel the load?" "Of course not," said the cynic, "because he's dead." "All right you are," said the priest. "This is also true for the one who was dead to Christ. He doesn't feel the weight of any sin." Sin is not only breaking some rule or a commandment. Sin is, in fact, expression of pride and a failure to be what God has called us to do and to be. It is refusing to let the Lord love us. It's a reluctance to worship Him. Sin is anything that creates distance between the Lord and even one another. And if the church speaks about sin, it is because the first sermon our Lord ever preached dealt precisely with the cure of sin. He said, "Repentance, repentance." And the last sermon he preached from the cross was this: "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." With Satan working overtime, let us remember that worshiping, confessing, and proclaiming and witnessing to the Lord must be more than a part-time hobby. Amen.
The grace of truth has shone forth.